Greetings, fellow blasphemers, and welcome to Bearpaw 72 on YouTube. On Saturday, June 28th, 2008, I finally had the hijinks of watching Ben Stein's Expelled, No Intelligence Allowed. The movie was originally released in the United States on April 18th, 2008. However, the Canadian release took place over a month later on June 27th, which is why this video was so yesterday. Even with my own limited scientific knowledge, I still recognize that Stein's story was entirely rigged. In any truly advanced society, creationism, also known as intelligent design, and you know it, does not belong in science class, but in Sunday school. Thankfully, when I went to a Catholic school back in the 1980s, the faculty was at least wise enough to keep both religious studies and science classes separate. Any effort to incorporate ID in the science classes, coupled with the headache stemming from the priest child molestation scandals, would have gotten my high school leveled for sure. But that's not all. I have become rather frustrated with the creationists' attempt to establish a direct link between the study of evolution and atheism. Two prime examples of this were Stein's interviews with Christopher Hitchens and, more importantly, Richard Dawkins. Both sides are on completely opposite ends, and thanks to people like Dawkins, who base their atheistic worldview on an acceptance of evolution, it's hard to establish a balance. I accept evolution, but the study of it will never convince me that there is no God and no afterlife. Ever. I was stumped to even fathom why some atheists consider evolution to be proof of the non-existence of the supernatural, thus helping to stage the rigged arguments of people like Stein. It took me until 2007 to realize that all the fuss about evolution was not really over the existence of the supernatural, but rather over the age of the earth. I had known for years that the Bible is so weak as a source for the evidence of a God that I have no more desire to take any of it seriously. Any book that commands you to pluck your eyes out for staring at a woman's ass is out of touch with Mother Nature anyway. The creationist argument against evolution is nothing more than an attempt to teach their own conflicting brand of abiogenesis, claiming that the universe is only 6,000 years old. I have become so obsessed with the age of the earth ever since I learned of the creationist argument that I am at my wit's end. Finally, any creationist documentary on evolution would not be complete without mentioning the Holocaust. Like other such documentaries before it, Expelled claims that Adolf Hitler's actions were based on an acceptance of evolution. Bologna. Hitler's intentions are not even remotely what evolution is about. Evolution is the study of how species change, mutate, branch, separate, variate, and strengthen over time. Aside from the fact that creationists say that Hitler was a Darwinist and atheists say that Hitler was a creationist, what the Nazis attempted was the creation of a completely homogeneous race with zero variation whatsoever, both ethnically and culturally. That's why 6 million Jews were killed. And even if the Nazis succeeded in killing all the non-Aryan people in the world, evolution dictates that their quest for a one-race world would have still constantly dragged on forever. On a small-town scale, one family might as well slaughter everyone not related to them, then repopulate the community through incest in a quest for a homogeneous race, and then slaughter every deformed baby produced from this to keep their race unblemished. This segment of Bearpaw 72 on YouTube was brought to you by an Earth that is older than 6,000 years old. Come and join it today. Don't miss part 3 of Tales of Venomfang X, coming soon. This has been Bearpaw 72 on YouTube. Thanks for watching. Bye now.